Hey guys, what's going on? It is CastlePerfect here, bringing you another live commentated Wi-Fi battle versus Effect 09, which is going to be a very good buddy of mine, because I've been talking to that guy for so freaking long. I've known him for a very long time. If you guys are interested in his channel, the link will be down in the description, of course. But before anything, I would like to start off the battle here. I would like to take a picture of the teams, obviously, because that way I can pretty much remember everything about them. So, wait, let me hold my phone straight, let it focus, got the picture. Now I got a picture of his team, and I can always double check his team. So, he's got a Scizor, Gardevoir, Rotom Heatform, a, what's it called again, the Dragon-type Pokemon, a, damn it, I forgot the name, a Sumareel, Meganium, and, what's his name again? Well, you guys probably know. I don't really have to tell you guys exactly what his name is. I'll remember his name later on in the game, I believe. But all right. So looking at his team, I'd say he has two Mega Evolutions, two possible Mega Evolutions, being the Scizor and the Gardevoir. It's kind of funny because we have Gardevoir on both teams, and his team is really not all that fast. I'd say that his team is quite slow, and there's somebody once again messaging me and stuff. I hate that, man. I'm trying to do something here and people just always have the tendency of sending me a message. But okay, so his team is pretty, I'd say, more defensive than offensive. And so is my team as well. So I think that his lead would be his Dragon-type Pokemon. So I would like to start off the battle with Kung Fu, which is going to be a new team member of this team. And Molly is making a comeback, though. And I have a Shiny Gardevoir this time. I have a Staraptor and a Latias. So I'm gonna see how this battle actually turns out. My team is going to be a little bit of a dick team, I would say, because me personally, I don't like to face these kind of teams because they are quite defensive, and there is a certain Pokemon on my team that likes to set up the screens, and breaking through the screens with Light Clay combination is gonna be really, really troublesome. So we're gonna see how this battle is actually going to be turn out. So, he's gonna lead up with Kung Fu. Oh, I'm actually gonna lead up with Kung Fu. He's gonna lead up with Rotom Heatform. Of course, I am going to start off the battle by going for a Fake Out. I wanna do a little bit of damage before I continue to pretty much, you know, do more damage. So the Fake Out is gonna happen. He's gonna be flinching here. And I don't see Leftovers, so I'd say he's choiced. He's absolutely choiced, and I think he's choice carved. So I am not going to risk him being choiced, scarfed, and then going for the Shadow Ball or Overheat or something like that. So I'm going to switch out here into Latias. I think he might just go for the Overheat, which would make sense. And even the Electric-type attacks and Fire-type attacks will be resisted by Jetto Rojo, which is going to be my Latias. And he goes for the Overheat just like I predicted, which is pretty good. Well, actually, it was quite a logical switch. So... Alright, so he's got 1, 2, 3 special attackers on his team, and 2 physical attackers. So I'd say he would switch out right now into Scizor or Gardevoir, but I think he's going to switch out into Scizor, if I'll be honest with you guys. Or he might just switch out into a Sumareel too, but I'm going to set up the Reflect here, because I think that's going to be really helping me out in the long run. So I'm going to go for that Reflect instead of the Light Screen, because I thought he would switch, but apparently he's going to stay, and he's not choiced. He is not choice, so I guess this is a Resto Chesto, a variant of Heatform, Rotom Heatform. So yeah, that's fine. You know, I'm gonna set up the Reflect here. He's most likely going to bring out Gardevoir now, because of course I am more vulnerable on my special defense side, and he's gonna do the exact same thing that I did predict. He will go for the Moonblast or a Will-O-Wisp, predicting the switch. So, huh? All right, interesting. I have the Psycho Shock, and okay, so Moonblast is what I'm gonna be predicting, and it sounds stupid, but I will stay in though. I will stay in and set up the Light Screen because I know I'm faster, and even if the Gardevoir has Mega Evolves, which it doesn't, so I'd say his Mega Evolution is going to be his Scizor. I hope I can take this Moonblast though. And I take it like a monster. Holy shit, man. This Latias is really, really, really bulky. I'm gonna go for the recover though on this turn, because I definitely don't want to lose Jetto Rojo, which should absolutely be an attack for Luffy in the One Piece anime. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about, just ignore what I just said. But okay, he's gonna go for another Moonblast, which is gonna do less damage, of course, and another. I think that I'm gonna be switching out now because I'm basically wasting the turns of the screens that I just set up. And it's funny that animation of Latias was just like going jets, going into his jet form or something. I don't know. But Moonblast is. Alright, so I'm gonna switch out into Raikou, and I'm just gonna go for the Thunderbolt, I think. No, I'm gonna go for the Fold Switch. Because there is really not much else that I can do, really. This is a shiny Raikou, by the way. This is the Event Raikou that has access to Aura Sphere and Zap Cannon and stuff. It's a really good Raikou, though. So I'm gonna start dealing damage here with the Fold Switch. I know he's gonna stay in, but I need to start dealing damage because what I'm doing right now is just basically wasting turns and taking damage for absolutely no reason. So he might just consider the switch out, or yeah, he's gonna switch out here, and I don't know what he's gonna go into because he might just predict like a Shadow Ball, I think. Yeah, he's gonna predict the Shadow Ball, I think, but whatever the case, he's gonna go out into Meganium, which is gonna be resistant to the Fold Switch, which is good to a certain extent, of course. And now we have the possibility to go out into what I believe is going to be the most powerful Pokemon on my team at this point, which is gonna be Staraptor, a Choice Banded Regulus Staraptor with access to Brave Bird and Double Edge. Now, Double Stab for absolutely destruction. So now I'll just have to take a look at what he has on his team. Brave Bird would be the better choice, of course, because even the Rotom Heat form is not gonna take it that well, and Double Edge is resisted by Scizor, and since I have no idea what kind of Scizor he's running, it might be a defensive variant, so Double Edge would not be good because he can always retaliate with Bullet Punch. So I'm just gonna go for the Brave Bird here, and you know, hope for the best. Or I could just go for the U-turn. Yeah, I might, no wait, I'm just gonna go for the U-turn, which sounds like a better plan to me because he will absolutely switch out here, there. I don't even know how I didn't think of that on the very first turn, though. Really stupid. So I'm gonna go for a U-turn here. I am going to switch out into what I believe is going to be Gardevoir. I'm gonna go for the Mega Evolution, and I'm gonna drop in with a Moonblast. Or a Hyper Voice, for that matter. Because this Gardevoir is a shiny Gardevoir, and I love the freaking Mega Evolution, though. It is so sweet, man. It gets like a green... I mean, green. It gets a black... it gets a black dress. It's like death. Death himself or herself. So I'm gonna go for the Mega Evolution and go for that Hyper Voice, which is gonna be boosted by the ability of Gardevoir, or Mega Gardevoir, which is going to be Pixelate, I think. That's what it is. And it's gonna turn normal type attacks into fairy type, and that is gonna give me the stab boost, and it's also going to give it a boost of, I think, a 33%. I'm not really sure, but the Hyper Voice is extremely powerful, and he's gonna live through it, obviously, because Fire Resist Fairy, and I did not think of that, so I'm playing quite bad right now. I need to pay more attention and see what else I can do. I mean, like, look at that freaking black dress. That's so crazy. That's just nuts, man. That's really crazy. I love it. But I'm going to switch out here. He's gonna go for the Bullet Punch, and even if it doesn't matter, really. Because Molly will absolutely take whatever this Scizor is about to throw at me, and it is going to be his Mega Evolution, that much I am certain of. And, yep, it's going to be really a really powerful Pokemon to deal with. I think that I'm just going to go for a Earthquake. I just want to deal damage to this thing because, you know, Mega Evolution Pokemons are really, really a Poke. Did I say Pokemons? Yeah, someone told me that it is actually Pokemon and not Pokemons. Even if I am talking about more than one Pokemon, it is always Pokemon, so... Alright, so he's gonna go for the Mega Evolution, just like I said. And he's most likely going to go for the Bullet Punch, or he might just predict the switch. No, he's gonna go for the Bullet Punch, predicted that, and Molly's gonna take... Oh my god, it basically takes no damage from that. That's crazy. That's... okay, so Reflect wears off now, and it took forever for those things to wear off. I cannot go for the knockoff because, of course, he has already Mega Evolve and you cannot knock off the Mega Stone. So, like I said, I'm just gonna go for... No, wait, I'm just gonna set up the Stealthrox, though. He might just go for the Swords Dance. No, he's gonna go for the U-turn. Alright, so that's fine. That's fine, I don't care about that. I need those rocks up because they will help me out take down the Rotom Heat Form, and they will be doing super effective damage to both Rotom Heat Form and the Dragon-type Pokemon, which I don't remember the name of, and I am getting a little bit frustrated because I don't know the name, so I'm actually going to go ahead and go to Serebii.net and just go ahead and check out his name, because it is ridiculous how I don't remember the name of this thing. Okay, so it's Noifern, that's what it is, Noifern, god damn it, how could I forget that? That's really stupid. So I'm gonna set up the rocks here, and Ice Shard will not take him out from that range, so I'm guessing he will just go for another Oath Hit, but, right, I'm gonna need Ice Shard for the Noifern, so I'll have to do something. Okay. Do I need Latias? That's a good question. I don't need Latias, actually, because Latias is really a setup Pokemon. That's all it does, or she does. And her only attacking move is going to be the Psy Shock. So, quite frankly, this is the best switching that I can have, or I can do at this point. She's gonna go for the Will-O-Wisp, which is fine. I don't care. It is better to have Latias, which is a specially orientated Pokemon. Burn rather than having Molly burn. So I'm gonna go for the recover now, and he just sent me a message, I think. No, he didn't. That's somebody else. And I'm gonna mute this again because, oh my god, so many people sending me messages whenever I am doing a Pokemon video. I don't get it. So he's gonna go for the overheat. Most likely thinking that I would like set up the reflect again before I go for the recover, but I'm definitely not gonna do that. So I'm gonna set up the reflect because I really need defensive support to deal with that Scizor. And just like I said, I told him at the very beginning before this battle actually started, I said I am using a team that is going to be an ass to deal with because these teams are so defensive, and like every single Pokemon complements each other. They are it's really difficult to get through this defense, so I wish him good luck doing whatever he wants to do. So I was gonna bring out his Scizor, which is most likely going to be the case, and he's gonna go for maybe a Pursuit, I don't know, but I think that I'm gonna be staying in and going to go for the Roost, because I think he might just go for the U-turn predicting the switch. I am so ahead of this battle right now, I don't even know, but he's taking his time thinking, of course, because I would do the same thing if I was in his situations. So he's gonna bring out the Scizor just like I thought, and he might just go for the U-turn. He might go for the U-turn predicting the switch instead of going for the Bullet Punch, and I think that a U-turn still will kill me, but I'll be honest with you guys, I got my Reflect up. He's got two specially orientated Pokemon, because Rotom Heatform is gonna die to its Stealthrox once it comes in again. There is no Focus Sashes on his team, so I'd say that I'll just stay in and go for the Psycho Shock, or Psy Shock, sorry. Yeah, he's gonna go for the U-turn, just like I predicted. I'm just gonna let Latias die, because Latias just did what she was supposed to do. So I get a crit before I die, so that's really unfortunate for him, but it's really awesome for me, so it's gonna take me out. I'm still gonna get the switch initiative, because I lost the Pokemon, and he will have to send out something else now, which I believe is going to be the Meganium. Of course, you send out your defensive Pokemon, or you send out the most offensive Pokemon that you have on your team when you are in such a situation. All he's thinking now is, what would be the better switch in? So he's gonna bring out a Sumeril, which is fine. A Sumeril has access to Belly Drum and Aqua Jet, so it always has access to priority, which is okay. No, I'm not gonna switch in Raikou because I'm not gonna be sending out Raikou because he can switch out into Meganium and I'll be just dealing damage to myself with Life Orb. I think that I will go out into Staraptor. I'm gonna go out into Staraptor. I'm just gonna go for the Brave Bird because basically everything on his team right now does not appreciate a Brave Bird, And he might just go for an Aqua Jet here to deal as much damage as he possibly can before he goes down. So, Brave Bird it is. Brave Bird everything. He's going to switch out, most likely going to, basically sacrifice his Rotom Heat for him, which is fine. I don't get any damage from it, which is good. And I think he's going to be bringing out his Scizor right now just to go for the Bullet Punch. Or maybe the Noifern just to outspeed me and go for a Dracomedia or something like that. I don't know. You guys be the judge. We're 15 minutes into this video right now, and I am taking the lead. I only lost one Pokemon. I think he's lost one Pokemon too. This is quite a long battle, though. I'm actually about to go all offensive, and he has Frisk! God damn it, so he knows that I'm Choice Banded. I can no longer, pretty much fake the Choice Scar of myself. Wow, that's not good. Alright, I'm thinking. Noifern has access to U-turn as well, so if I switch out into Gardevoir and he U-turns out, brings out Scizor, I'm in a predicament. But if he goes for the Draco Meteor, or a Dragon-type attack, I think that I will not be affected, because I'm a Fairy-type. But whatever the case, I'm just gonna switch out into Gardevoir, because really that's like the safest switch that I have right now. Molly is, physically defensive, so he won't be able to take those special attacks relatively well. So he's gonna go for the Draco Meteor. I avoid the damage, which is absolutely fantastic. And right now, I am just gonna go for a Hyper Voice or a Will-O-Wisp. I could go for the Will-O-Wisp predicting the switch. Yeah, Will-O-Wisp predicting the switch into Scizor would be a really good move. Now that the Rotom Heat form is out of the way, there is really not much on his team that appreciates a burn, so I'm actually gonna go for the Will-O-Wisp instead of going for the Hyper Voice, which is super effective against the Noifern. So I am predicting either the Scizor or the Azumarill. No, he's gonna go out into Gardevoir. Okay, well, that's fine. Don't care that much about that. Will-O-Wisp is gonna happen, and he's gonna be burned. She's gonna be burned, though. And, crazy. Synchronize, of course. Well, that's a good move, though. Not gonna give him that. That's a good move. I should have gone for the Hyper Voice then, but I'm gonna do it now. Hyper Voice all the way, do as much damage as I possibly can. And oh my god, another critical. I don't deserve those critical hits. I hate those critical hits, man. They are really, it's not good, man. I don't like it. Wow, this is so unfair, though. It's really unfair. I don't like it, really. So his Gardevoir is gonna go down to the burn, and he's lost one more Pokemon. He has four Pokemons left, being the Scizor, Noifern, Meganium, and Azumarill. And either the Scizor or the Azumarill is gonna be switched in right now, because I don't believe he's gonna bring out his Noifern, because obviously he's choiced in some way, I think. And it's gonna be Azumarill, and of course he's gonna go for the Aqua Jet after this. And I don't think I have anything else on my team which is going to be able to take that relatively well. So I guess I should let Gardevoir die? I don't know, really. I do not know. I think that's gonna be the best thing to do, actually. I'm gonna leave Gardevoir in to die, and I'm gonna bring out my Staraptor, and we're gonna be trading blows here like crazy. So I'm just gonna go for that Hyper Voice. He's gonna go for the Aqua Jet, save move all the way. He's playing pretty safely ever since this match started. Another critical hit, which did not matter. Obviously, the other one actually did not matter neither, because of course it would have been a 2-hit KO anyway. But still, those critical hits are not nice. I don't like them. Okay. Raikou. Okay, so Raikou, Fault Switch, nope, because his Meganium is still around, so I'd say Staraptor, do your thing. Brave Bird all the way, dude. Brave Bird everything. Let's go. Brave Bird. Of course he's gonna let his Azumarill die, which that's what I believe, though. And, because, you know, Noifern is really fast, and it basically outspeeds everything else on my team. And he's gonna go for the Aqua Jet, which is fine. Reckless Brave Bird Choice Bandit is gonna rape some face right now. So, just like I thought, it will just leave his Azumarill to die here. Because quite frankly, his Noifirm, his Scizor, and Meganium are Pokemons that he does need in order to defeat me. So down goes his Azumarill and the Reflect wears off, finally! So, I completely forgot about the Reflect though. Ever since Latias died, I was like, yeah, I don't have Reflect up, I don't have screens up anymore. But I'm not used to play with the screens because, I don't know, I don't do that. So, he's gonna bring out this thing, and once again, he's possibly going to try and go for another Drago Meteor. And my most expandable Pokemon at this point is absolutely my Raikou, because Raikou cannot really outspeed Noifirm. It will take damage from the Bullet Punch, from the Scizor, and Meganium pretty much walls him, so I am going to sacrifice Raikou because I absolutely need this Staraptor to go for the Brave Bird at some point in time once the Meganium is in. Alright. It's unfortunate that I'm not running Quick Attack on my my Staraptor, but he's going to go for the Draco Meteor. He's going to take down the Raikou, which I believe so. Yeah, he does. He takes me out. Special attack drops drastically. And yeah, I'm in a very good position right now, I'd say. Another Draco Meteor will absolutely take me down, that much I'm certain of. I did not pay attention if this Noifirm is actually Life Orb, Choice Bandit, or whatever it is. I did not pay attention, which is gonna possibly gonna bite me in the ass. And I'm gonna bring out Molly now. And I'm gonna scare him off with the Ice Shard. Yep, that's what I'm gonna do, but I'm gonna try and go for... No, I'm just gonna scare him off with the Ice Shard, and he will switch out into his Scizor, or most likely Meganium, because Meganium can deal with Molly really easily. So, I'm gonna double switch into Staraptor. Yeah, it's gonna happen. He's gonna go into his Meganium. Yeah, absolutely good prediction on my part. Now I'm gonna be able to fire off another Brave Bird and take care of this Meganium. And after that, he will most likely bring out the Noifirm again and revenge kill me, which I'm gonna allow it to happen because really, I don't have any other choice. Alright, so in comes Staraptor and I'm gonna go for that Brave Bird. Gonna go for the Brave Bird, absolutely. I could have gone for the U-turn, but I don't see the point in doing that. So, alright, so he's taking his time. I don't know if... I think, absolutely, his most expendable Pokemon at this point is gonna be his Meganium. And if he doesn't, like, let his Meganium die at this point, then he's gonna be in for a world of trouble, though, because he's gonna need that Scizor really badly. And the Draco Meteor from the Noifirm is really, really packing a punch. So I really don't know how this battle is actually gonna turn out to be, because Molly really, the only counter to Molly at this point, sorry, voice crack, is going to be the Meganium, and once I get rid of the, okay, so he knows that the Meganium is really not a Pokemon he wants to spend, you know, he wants to, like, let die right now, so, alright, so Frisk is gonna once again show up. And the choice band is gonna be refilled. Gonna go with a Brave Bird, which is great. And down goes the Noifirm. So this is a really big twist to my whole strategy, which I thought it would like it would. I thought it would sacrifice his Meganium though, but it doesn't. So in comes Scizor, which is absolutely going to go for the Bullet Punch. But I don't know, man. I don't know, man. Molly can pretty much wall that Scizor and take him down in two hits. I can absolutely sponge two hits, so... how many Pokemon? I have three Pokemon left. And I think that Kung Fu is gonna be the Pokemon that I want to sacrifice right now, because Molly is irreplaceable right now, and I am absolutely going to need Staraptor for that Meganium at some point. I just hope he doesn't go for the Swords Dance right now, because then it's pretty much game over. Alright, so he's gonna go for the Bullet Punch. That's gonna bring me down to below half. Yep, he's gonna do that. I'm gonna go for the Fake Out. Just to do as much damage as I possibly can before I go down. There goes the Fake Out. He's absolutely going to spam that Bullet Punch because why not? And he's gonna go for another Stone Edge. Or I'm just gonna go for a high jump kick instead. It doesn't really matter because it's gonna take me out with a bullet punch. Alright, that happens, and Khufu goes down. Another critical hit. How many critical hits have happened so far? I think a couple of six or something. Yeah, six or something. I don't know. But in comes Mowgli. And right now, this is pretty much the decisive, I forgot the word. But this is gonna be the moment that is going to reveal which one of us is going to win this battle. If I double switch into Staraptor and he ends up switching out into his Meganium, I win this game. But if he just goes for a bullet punch right now, and I end up switching out into Staraptor, I lost this game because Meganium is gonna kill Mowgli. So, I have two choices. Either I stay in and go for the Earthquake and risk him switching out into Meganium, or I double switch out into Staraptor and predict the switch into Meganium. So, I'd say I'll go with my guts and I will predict if it actually ends up being a bad choice, then so be it. It was absolutely a close game. But let's do it. Alright, I'm gonna switch out Mowgli. I'm gonna bring out Staraptor, and apparently he's just gonna go for the bullet punch. He's gonna go for the U-turn! If I leave that though, if I... Oh my god, I'm gonna leave it! I am going to leave it, and he... Oh man, you're in for a world of trouble, brother. You are in for a world of trouble. I am going to go for the Brave Bird. Now the thing is here, if he... Okay, so the game can still be switched around though. If I go for the Brave Bird and I take down his Meganium, or no, if he switches out right now and sacrifices his Seasword, the Rico will kill me, and then it will be a face-off between Mowgli and Meganium, and I'll still be losing this game. And close combat will not kill Meganium. God damn it, man, decisions. This game is close, though. This game is really close. Alright, so... Brave Bird, and I'll kill myself with recoil, or close combat, and then just go for a Ice Shard. But will the Ice Shard kill? That's the question. I know there's gonna be a lot of people in the comment section below like, yo, you should have gone for this move, or no, you should have gone for that other move, and then you would have won this battle. I don't know, guys. I really don't know. Close combat, how much damage would I do? I don't think it will do that much, so I'm just gonna go for the Brave Bird. I don't care, let's go, Brave Bird everything. He's gonna do exactly what I thought he would do. I'm gonna kill myself with recoil, and it's gonna be a face-off between Mowgli... Meganium. So, I just lost this game, but it was absolutely a close game, and I don't have any regrets. So, yeah, an absolute good game. And I'm gonna leave with... Oh, it's not game over! It is not game over! Staraptor leaves, hangs on with 7 HP, thanks to that Stealthrox that I set up earlier. Oh my god, what a close game. Once again, guys, this is... I love this game. Guys, if you really support this kind of series, live commentated Wi-Fi battles, remember to drop a like, man. Because this game is so close. Staraptor coming through. Coming through. Alright, so everybody sit down and eat some popcorns because the game is over. Now I just go to sleep. I don't even know what I'm talking about. So that's gonna be the game, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Double down at the very end. I win this battle because Mowgli hangs on with life. And it's gonna be a 1-0. A hell of a close game. Once again, guys, if you want to support this series, remember to, you know, like up this video and then leave down a comment section. Leave down a comment in the comment section below talking about what you did today or something, I don't know, something related to this video, I don't know, whatever, it doesn't matter, I always read my comments, so thank you very much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys later.